Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel.
Well, he's one of the more accomplished strikers in this division. Sprawl and brawl, whatever you want to say, he's going to try to keep this fight standing tonight.
It does not matter how he accomplishes it. All he wants to do is be on his feet and at range, hitting you with the beautiful jab, staying away from the grappling exchanges. You don't accomplish all the things that this man has accomplished over the course of his career without understanding distance. He has great distance management, which then in turn allows him to land all these beautiful diverse kicks, spinning back kick, jumping high kick, so many things he possesses that he will try to use tonight in this fight.
Yeah, if this turns into a kickboxing match tonight, most people believe, yeah, his opponent is in a world of trouble. Well, you can argue this is the most influential martial artist of all time, the great Bruce Lee, making his walk to the octagon here tonight, champ.
Everybody wants to be Bruce Lee. They say they want to be like Mike. If you're a fighter, you want it to be like Bruce Lee. You want it to be that fast. You want it to be that charismatic. You want it to have an ability to just freeze your opponents. Your speed, your movement, just the diversity in the attacks that you can give your opponents would just confuse people. I mean, I watched him beat a 7-foot Kareem Abdul-Jabbar to stay undefeated.
Right.
If you could do that, you could do anything.
I fear not the man who has practiced 10,000 kicks once, but I fear the man who has practiced one kick 10,000 times. Bruce Lee in a nutshell.
Just so wise.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Bergliata. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 6'6" tall, weighing in at 258 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, USA, Big. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'7" tall, weighing in at 145 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, USA, Bruce the Dragon Lee.
All right, commit to the rules in the locker room. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. I want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
You ready? You ready?
All right, here we are inside the home of the New York Knicks. It is Madison Square Garden, and I think a lot of people remember when Conor McGregor and Eddie Alvarez ushered in this building as far as the UFC is concerned back in 2016.
I mean, that place was insane when Conor McGregor became the UFC's double champion. From outside of the arena, they build up to the fight, to in the arena when Conor became the king. This was a great moment in the world's greatest arena. Look, the best fights in history have happened here. And on that night, Conor McGregor etched his name in stone.
And there comes the separation now. Well, you saw the tail of the tape. He has a reach advantage and made good use of it there with that punch.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up? Ooh, head kick lands and hurt.
Oh, beautiful strike attempt there as he lands the hook.
Beautiful hook. Really did a great job of keeping his back hand on his chin, throwing that hook and putting it exactly where he needs it to go. And everything's landing with so much power.
use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Lee.
He's throwing every part of himself into these big leg kicks.
Nice kicks there by Lee. Big left hand there inside. Just missed on that spinning attack.
Look at how he turns his hip into that leg kick.
Back to the left hand now, unable to connect. Oh!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, straight right.
Oh! Oh!
Oh! The jab followed by the right hand. Just missing on the uppercut there. Slips to avoid the right.
Can't take many of those, you better check.
Oh, nice land with the knee. Wow.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks. Beautiful punch.
All right, 20 seconds to go in the round. Just missing on the high kick there. All right, now we take a look back at some of the highlights. He has had his kicking game going early and often tonight.
I mean, on point, right? He knew that this was going to be a way for him to take control of this fight. He's used those kicks to really put him out ahead, and I'm not sure if his opponent has the ability to adjust and stop him from landing these over and over.
Nice job to land the straight punch there. Must be nice to have that kind of reach advantage, DC. I know you can't necessarily relate. All right, well, he's landed some good shots tonight, but there's no three-piece, there's no soda. More often than not, it's one and done.
He's not even getting a combination. I mean, if you're gonna sit there at the drive-thru, order a combination, take the soda with your food, give him the right hand behind
him.
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
That one appeared to stun him. Right hook to the head blocked.
Liver kick, if you take those kicks, it's gonna shut your body off. What a punch. Over and over, he's landing these big body kicks. You take more of these leg kicks, you will not be able to be very active on your feet.
Both fighters hanging down in the pocket and both landing. So a much different approach for him here in this second round. He was a little bit tentative in round one, a little bit of a feeling out process. Now he has clearly found his rhythm, found the range. We'll see if he can continue with more activity here in round two.
Good punch land.
Oh, outstanding placement as he lands the knee to the body. Again, the taller fighter making noise with a knee strike there.
I mean, look at the commitment to kicking in this fight.
Again, he's looking for that left. It's not there. All right, so a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be, and if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming. It's very tricky when he throws that body kick. Big, powerful punch land. Now he gets back to range.
Oh, he might be out.
Yep.
Final seconds here. Two rounds in the books. All right, so a huge round for him there. Nearly had him out of there with the head kick. Did get the knockdown. Talk us through the replay.
He got the knockdown. He won the round. He did everything correct. The only thing he didn't do is finish the fight. But if he continues down the path, if he continues to do the exact same thing as he did before, he will get that finish.
This is a world-class display of striking here tonight. Whiffs on the elbow. Lands with the kick there. No pad on that foot.
No shin guard. He's taking all of that kick every time he throws.
So a big knockdown for him in the previous round. Confidence is high and building here in this next round.
Confidence is key, and he has a ton of it right now.
Oh, and he connects with a punch there, DC. You like this guy.
I like this guy a ton, and to watch his punch, I just put a smile on my face. Beautiful body kick.
Come on, buddy. Keep your hands up. Let's go.
Well, you see him land the jab there. He's got the reach advantage and might as well use it. Oh! And just like that, the fight is over. Yeah, brutal elbow to stop his opponent right there in his tracks, and it really takes strong technique to deliver a shot like that to maximize force over a short distance. But man, when guys do it right with those elbows, it is absolutely devastating. All right, DC, no telestrator tonight, but we're gonna get you some highlights from this one. This was a fight that had it all, and for my money, his best performance to date.
His best performance to date in the biggest moment. In the biggest moments, you gotta show up, and that's exactly what he did tonight. He used every bit of his skill to get the job done.
We go inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliano has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 53 seconds of the third round, declaring the winner by...
Thank you for watching. Please wait for more videos. See you soon.
Knockout for him to get this win in style.